Hello, 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 hello. Wait for a couple more people to get in here before I start. Maybe play a little love song while I wait for y'all to join. Hopefully it doesn't kick me off. Hello. Hello, Mike. Welcome, 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 welcome.
Welcome.
Shout out to No Filter DC. Garden DC. Welcome to the chat. Tonight's conversation, I'm hoping, will be more interactive. Give the comments. I would love to hear all of your thoughts on how love is a verb. So many people use your name in vain. Love, those who have faith in you sometimes go astray. Love, through all the ups and downs of joy and hurt. Love, better or worse, I still will put you first. I'm gonna start in a minute. Just trying to give some more people time to join in on the combo. Welcome to the chat. I hope y'all stick around for the conversation. I mean, hope y'all interact and talk to me about love. Little fade out. All right, welcome, welcome, welcome to Women Wednesdays. My name is Soul. I am a community health social media influencer. I am the host of Floetic Uptown as well as the Back Series, which is tonight at 7:30 on Zoom. You can click the link in our bio as well as a No Filter DC bio to join us at 7:30. We have Grooves by DJ Sean Don tonight, and it's our last bag series of 2020. So it's really exciting. We'll also be in the corner, DC, which is Whitman-Walker's Cultural Center, and we have a new exhibit called See They're Making History at Whitman-Walker, and you'll be able to see some of the pieces that are in the show if you tune into the bag series. And I'm also an art educator there, so yes, that is my full intro. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and they, them. As long as you're respectful, I'm pretty good on answering to those pronouns. So let's get right into tonight's topic. Hey Chi. So today's topic is love as a verb. This topic was important, and I think a good way to end the year out, just because, you know, love isn't just a feeling, it is something that you do. Yes, it's something that you do and act on. To love is to do, to feel, to become. Love is not passive or still. Love is a continuous movement and change and growth, adapting to fit, making space in your heart for someone else. And because love isn't a one-time thing, thought or feeling, it's a continual action and continual choice and promise to another person that makes love a verb. Yes, so feel free to start talking in the comments about ways that you act on your love and show love. Because like I said, love is a movement towards one another. Even through the chaos of this life, especially this year, love has been, you know, actively searching for ways to be closer and to understand and to meet each other halfway. In a pandemic, we've had to reassess how we're showing love to people, right? Like, we can't, you know, give hugs as often as we would like to. We can't share space in the same ways that we're used to. We can't dance. We can't, you know, just pop up and be spontaneous and, you know, do something nice. Like, everything kind of has to be a little bit more planned and more cautionary. So if you've, you know, learned any new ways this year on how to love, please feel free to add them in the comment. In the comments, love is looking at someone and deciding that you want to love them even when they mess up, even when they fall down, even when they're not the same person, even when they fight with you or they make you cry. Love is kissing someone and finding ways to be passionate towards them, even when there are thousands of distractions, like other people that you may be attracted to, or, you know, work, or you have other emotional distractions. It's still important that we are showing each other love and leaning on each other. Love is choosing to push away temptation and focusing on who your person is and how the two of you can grow together. Love is walking away from people and things that hinder who you have the potential to become, you know. And love can be so many things, like No Filter DC says. It can be romantic, platonic, a friendship, long-term, something that's in the moment, everything. And it's really important to acknowledge that there are so many other different types of love, right? And it's not just romance, right? Like, platonic love and friendship are extremely important. You know, the love that you have with your family members is extremely important. And I think it's from a young age, we like learn how to love through what we see in our households. And sometimes that can be a good thing and sometimes that can be a bad thing. But when we grow up and into adults, we get to now choose and learn more about our love languages and how to love and how and what healthy love is, in all facets, you know. Romance, platonic, friendship, relationships. And it's important to note that loving yourself first is also like the best way to learn how to love other people, you know. Once you achieve like a level of self-love where you can acknowledge your boundaries and communicate them, it opens up space for other people to feel comfortable sharing their own boundaries and like being communicating what they need from you, and how they need you to show them love. And it's also important to know like love languages, you know. There are 5 different love languages, right? And these are all important in like self-love, platonic love, romance. But I want to share them because I think it's important that when you're thinking about love languages, you're thinking about your love language, but you're also thinking about other people's love languages. You're not just you're not trying to just show love based off of your love language, but you're learning other people's love languages and loving them and acting in that way. So there are 5 love languages. The first one is words of affirmation, which is my number one love language. People with words of affirmation as a love language really value verbal acknowledgments of affection, like frequent I love yous, compliments, words of appreciation, verbal encouragement, and like texts and written letters and that type of stuff. The second love language is quality time. And those people who love quality time feel like the most loved and adored when the people around them or their partners are actively making time to spend with them and are always down to hang out. And they particularly love when that the quality time is like active listening and eye contact and full presence, you know. It's about kind of giving undivided attention to this person. So without the distraction of a television or a phone or any other outside interference, those type of people who, you know, love quality time, like I also love quality time, they have a strong desire to actively spend time with their significant other and have meaningful conversations or share recreational activities. The next love language is acts of service. If your love language is acts of service, you value when your partner goes out of your way to make your life easier. It's things like bringing you soup when you're sick, or making you coffee in the morning, or picking up your dry cleaning for you when you've had a busy day at work, or, you know, even knowing that, you know, you're 10 minutes away, so they put your dinner in the microwave for you so that it's hot and warm for you, you know. Little things like that, just to show that you care and you're thinking of them, are ways to show those people those acts of service love languages. And then there's gifts as a love language. Gifts is a pretty straightforward, you know. You feel loved when people give you visual symbols of loves. And it's not necessarily about like the monetary value. It's more like symbolic. So if somebody has a love language of gifts, it can even just be as simple as like, oh, I was in the grocery store today and I saw your favorite snacks, and so I bought you like 2 bags of your favorite snacks so that you wouldn't have to get them yourself. Or, you know, I'm clearly a foodie, so like all of my examples have to do with food. But yeah, just little things like that. People whose love languages is receiving gifts just enjoy being gifted with something that is both physical and meaningful. The key is to give meaningful things that matter to them and reflect their values and not necessarily yours. And then the last love language is physical touch. People with physical touch as their love language feel loved when they receive physical signs of affection, including kissing, holding hands, cuddling on the couch, and safe sex. Physical intimacy and touch can be incredibly affirming and serve as a powerful emotional connector for people with this love language. And I know the physical touch people are struggling right now in the pandemic, but I hope that you all have been finding other ways to safely show love to the people with physical touch love languages. And if that just means even like, I don't know, here's one idea, right? Physical touch can also kind of like, you can get somebody a teddy bear, right? And make it smell like you and give it to your partner so that they can kind of, they can have this physical touch with this inanimate object, but like it can represent you, you know? So those are, that's an idea for anybody who is looking for a way to help out their physical touch love language partner. Other things I want to say about love as a verb. Sometimes we confuse love and lust, and we mistake like silly giddiness for commitment. I want to go ahead and like talk about the differences between love and lust. Love is a deep feeling of affection that you have for another person. It's a lasting attraction that that goes beyond the surface and turns into emotional attachment, and is not just based off of physical attraction or like sexual tension. And lust, on the other hand, is basically like just simply a physical attraction that leads to an overwhelming feeling of sexual desire. Two people deeply in lust can easily stay up all night enjoying themselves in each other's company, but it won't be like a stimulating conversation that keeps them awake. It'll more than likely be, you know, again, physical attraction and touch. And two people in love are, you know, just interested in each mm-hmm. other's minds and
mm-hmm.
yes.
Should I?
Yes. Sorry, guys.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Two people who are in love are just as interested in each other's minds as they are in each other's bodies. And they can easily lose track of time when doing nothing more than just talking to one another. They're never stuck for a topic of conversation, and even if they don't agree on everything, they're intrigued and captivated by each other's minds. Love can be a verb by, you know, making your partner a sandwich even when you don't feel like it. You know, love can be recognizing that intimate and committed relationships are crucibles inside which both partners will be asked to grow emotionally and spiritually and learn about the barriers that prevent them from loving. Love can mean like posting sticky notes around your partner's room to affirm them. Love means, you know, learning each other's love languages, like I said, and implementing them and how you communicate. Love is definitely communicating, okay? Love is the action. Love is choosing to act on your feelings, you know, on your emotional, feelings for someone. And, you know, doing what you can to show them that you love them. Does anybody love is also going to get tested, okay? And adding safe sex tools to your bag, you know? It's getting HIV and STI tested regularly. It's, you know, maybe taking PrEP or PEP. It's, you know, using birth control. It's, you know, talking about what both of you want in the future. And you know, really implementing safe practices into your relationship. Yeah, that's pretty much the gist of what I wanted to say today. I would really love for y'all to join the bag later tonight so we can talk through love as a verb even more while we dance and vibe to the grooves by DJ Sean Don. Like I said, we'll be in the corner today. It's our last bag series of the year. So all three of us will be together in the corner, and we're really looking forward to talking about this and dancing and ending the year on a lovely note. So I hope I will see you there. Until next time, be well, take care of yourselves, wear a mask, wash your hands, social distance, and be safe.